Australia's statistical X-ray, better known as the Census, has revealed a nation becoming less religious, with fewer couples living with children and fewer households living in properties they own outright. It also marks the end of the dominance of the baby boomer, caught up at last by the millennial generation. And National Affairs editor Hugh Rimmington crunches the numbers.
It's the eternal Australian question.
So where the bloody hell are you?
Not that one, this one.
Who the bloody hell are we?
The census numbers show a nation in rapid change. Gough Whitlam came to power to rule over 12 million people.
Congratulations, Mr. Whitlam.
Well, thank you.
We've more than doubled in the 50 years since, approaching 26 million, with more than 2 million added in the last 5 years. Indians have now vaulted over Chinese and Kiwis as a migrant source, a move Amar Singh has felt since coming here at 15.
I was probably the only brown person in the whole school, but now it's becoming more multicultural and we're accepting of others' faiths, traditions and backgrounds, which is great. I think it's a great place for our kids to grow up.
The census, taken at the height of the lockdowns, found 5.8 million Australians suffering at least one long-term health issue. Mental health is number one. 2.2 million of us say we're affected, and the experts believe that still understates the problem.
I think it's probably reasonable to assume that there are a lot more other Australians out there who are living with problems with mental health.
And we are losing our religion. 10 years ago, more than 60% of us identified as Christian, in a single decade that has plunged to less than 44%. In the same decade, no religion has almost doubled, from 22% to nearly 40%. Among millennials, those aged 25 to 39, nearly half declared themselves as having no religion.
And increasingly, millennials matter. They've just taken over the baby boomers as the largest demographic group in Australia, a voting and purchasing powerhouse that's increasingly reshaping our economy and our politics.
We are trapped for longer in debt. When John Howard became Prime Minister, nearly 42% of Australians owned their house outright without a mortgage. By last year, that could be said of just 30% of us. The number of households made up of couples without children is also rising, now approaching 50% of all homes. With migration then left to drive population growth, another new tipping point. More than half of us now were born overseas, or has a parent who was. And that's who we are. Hugh Rimmington for 10 News First.